everyone, and welcome to Faith at Home. I'm Miss Amy.
And I'm Mrs. Taylor.
And we are going to sing some songs and do some story reading, and it's going to be a great day. Let's start with a song. This song, we're just going to sing the refrain, but it's called I Am the Church. Are you ready? It's really easy. Here we go. I am the church, you are the church, we are the church together. Jesus all around the world. Yes, we're the church together. Good job.
So today we're going to hear a story from the Growing in God's Love Story Bible, and it's the last story that we're going to hear from our friend Jacob. And who remembers what this guy's called?
I do. Esau.
And he had red hair and he was kind of hairy. So, this story is the last one about them. Here's a picture of them. Okay. Have you ever fought with your brother or your sister or one of your friends? I bet that you have. Did that person make you really, really angry? Sometimes I know watching my boys that they definitely pick on each other and sometimes they don't want to forgive each other. Has that ever happened to you? It isn't easy to stop being mad at someone, but that's what God wants us to do. Jacob and Esau were brothers, and they knew what it was like to get over a fight. So today, we're going to hear a story about how they get along in the very end. So last week, we learned about Jacob wrestling with God. After that, Jacob packed up his family, and he left the river where he wrestled with God. And that's also the river where he got a new name. Do you remember Jacob's new name? Anyone? God changed Jacob's name to Israel, which means God is always with you. So Jacob set out to reunite with his brother. And when Jacob left, he went with his whole family, his new family. So he had wives and he had children. He actually had 12 children that are become the 12 tribes of Israel. And one of them you actually have heard a lot about before. Joseph. Do you guys remember Joseph? He has like the fancy coat and he gets thrown in the pit. It's that Joseph. So Jacob is Joseph's dad. So that just kind of helps you remember who's who. So Jacob's marching along and he is all brave now because he knows that God is with him no matter what. Always, always, always. So he has courage to face up to Esau and apologize. Now Esau knew that Jacob was coming. And so Esau didn't know if Jacob was still going to be a big meanie. And so he got 400 strong men to come and fight Jacob. But Jacob had a new name and courage because God was with him. When he saw the strong 400 strong men with Esau, guess what? Jacob was scared. He was really, really scared. He gathered his whole family around him, and he had lots and lots of family with him. And so he hoped that maybe his family would protect him. Do you think your family protects you? I think they do. So they all marched up to where Esau was, and guess what happened? Esau forgave him. He ran over to him, and he gave him a big, big hug, and he gave him a kiss, and they forgave each other. So then Jacob said, I brought you presents. So he brought him some cows and some grain. He brought him all kinds of big presents. And he bowed down, and he bowed down before him and on the ground and kneeled. And he put his head down to the ground 7 times and said, I'm sorry. And that's what God wants us to do. He wants us to say we're sorry. Esau could have sent his 400 strong men to kill Jacob. But Esau didn't choose to do that, did he? He could have gotten even, but he didn't choose that way. Esau chose to forgive. Sorry, I have to turn the page. Jacob said, I apologize, and Esau said, I forgive you. Jacob and Esau got over it. They were brothers again. Jacob was so happy, and he said, when you wrapped your arms around me, Esau, it felt like God was hugging me. And I want you to take my present. And Esau took the present, and they forgave each other, and that is how two brothers reunite and start over again. So what can When you get mad at someone, like your brother or your sister or friend, do you need to forgive them? You do. You need to say you're sorry, and then if you're on the other side of it and someone does something wrong to you, you need to forgive them. Because God wants us to love everyone, no matter what. The end.
Thank you, Mrs. Taylor. That was a great story. It's really important to forgive one another. Sometimes it's hard, but it's still important. You guys can do it. I know you can. Shall we say a prayer together? Here we go. God made the sun. God made the sea. God made the fishes, and God made me. We thank him for the sun. We thank him for the sea. We thank him for the fishes, and we thank him for me. Great job. Should we end with a closing song? How about I Am the Light of the World? Let's sing it. Ready?
I am the light of the world. I am the light of the world. Whoever follows me will never walk in the dark. Will never walk in the dark, but have the light of life.
Great job. See you next time.